Welcome back, children. Let's begin the next chapter, chapter 6, Omana's journey. But before that, tell me, you all love vacations, don't you? Vacations are the time we get to meet our relatives, cousins, grandparents, uncles and aunts. It is so much fun to travel by train, bus or planes to different places, isn't it? Today, we will read a story about Omana and her journey. Her journey by train from Ahmedabad to Kozhikode. Omana describes her wonderful experience in the form of a diary. So let's start reading. Chapter 6. Omana's journey. Omana and her best friend Radha were very excited. They were going on a train trip to Kerala. Omana was going to her grandmother's house and Radha was going with her family for a holiday. Omana's father had gone to book train tickets for both the families. Then, just 2 days before their journey, Radha fell down from her bicycle and fractured her right leg. Her leg was put in plaster. The doctor said that she should not move her leg for 6 weeks. Radha's family had to cancel their tickets. The two friends were very sad. They had made so many plans about what they would do together on the trip. Then Radha's Amma had an idea. Omana, why don't you write down everything about your trip in a diary? Then when you come back, Radha can read all about your trip. This way, you will not forget anything and it will also help you pass the time on the train. Both the friends thought this was a good idea. Omana went home and found a notebook with blank pages to write all about her journey. Here are some pages from Omana's diary for you to read. Omana and Radha were going to travel together by train with their families. Omana's father had booked their train tickets from the railway reservation counter. Here you have to stand in a queue to buy your train tickets. The booking clerk sitting behind the booking window books your tickets. So Omana's father had booked the tickets for both the families. Do you know, children? Nowadays, you don't have to stand in long queues at the railway station to buy your train tickets. We can also buy them online. Like how we are doing our online classes. So we can also buy the railway tickets online. Sitting at home, you can do it on your mobile phone or on the laptop. Okay? Using the online reservation portal of the Indian Railways, that is IRCTC. Okay. See, children, they would be traveling from Ahmedabad in Gujarat to Kozhikode in Kerala. The train would start from Gandhidham in Kutch. You can see in the map that they would be traveling a very long distance, covering the 4 states of Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, the train would finally reach Kozhikode in Kerala, covering a distance of 2,165 kilometers in 36 and a half hours. That is more than 1 day. Okay? Almost 2 days. So, they have to travel such a long distance. The friends were very excited, but unfortunately, 2 days before the journey, Radha fractured her leg and her family had to cancel their tickets. Both the girls were very sad because they had planned to do so many things together during the journey. Then, Radha's mother suggested that Omana should write her experiences in the form of a diary. It would serve two purposes. Radha would get to know everything that Omana did and Omana also would not get bored. Shall we now read Omana's diary? 16 May. As soon as we reached the station, we checked our names on the reservation chart. Soon the train reached the platform. We saw that the coach was already full. The train had started early in the morning from Gandhidham in Kutch. When the train came, there was so much confusion. People were getting off and others were pushing and trying to put their luggage inside, all from one door. So they reached the station. and they checked the names on the reservation chart. Now, as soon as the train reached the platform, they saw that the coach was already full. Why was it full? Because it was coming from Gandhidham. Okay, so by the time it came to Ahmedabad, there were already a lot of passengers in the train. When the train came, there was so much confusion. Why is there confusion when there is a train at the platform? Because so many people want to get down, so many people want to get into the train, and they all want to do it at the same time. They want to push their luggage in, throw their luggage out. So there is total chaos. There's a lot of confusion at the platform whenever the train comes. Okay, so this is what she saw. We somehow managed to get in, find our seats and put our luggage under them. By the time the train started, most people had found their seats and arranged their luggage. After some time, the ticket collector came and checked our tickets to see that we were in our proper seats. Amma and Appa had the lower berths. Unni and I have the middle berths. There are two college students who have the upper berths. On the other berths, there is a family with two children. They seem to be about our age. I will go and talk to them later. Now I'm sitting near the window and I've started writing about our journey, just as I had promised you. I will stop now because Amma has opened the tiffin box. Amma had packed a lot of food, dhokla with chutney, lemon rice and some mithai. My mouth is watering. I will write more later. See the questions on page number 49. Why was it so crowded at the door of the coach? Can you tell me? Yes, because the people who were getting down and the people who wanted to get into the train were trying to do so at the same time. And they were also trying to push in their luggage. Okay, and so the door was so crowded. Have you ever traveled in a train? When? Now children, you can write about your experience here. Okay, when you have traveled. Okay, and where have you gone to? So you can write that here. What food would you like to take when you travel and why? Now when you write this, you should remember that the food that we carry on our train journeys should not get spoiled soon, because the train journeys are pretty long, right? So the food should not get spoiled. So we carry food accordingly. So you can write here what food you carry when you travel. Okay? What does the ticket checker do? The ticket checker goes from coach to coach and checks everybody's tickets. Okay, and those people who are not traveling with tickets, he can find them. Okay, how will you recognize the ticket checker? The ticket checker wears a uniform. Okay, they usually wear a black coat and with the name tag on them. Okay, let us read her diary. 16th May. After lunch, some people slept. But I was not sleepy. I kept looking out of the window. I saw many fields, but they all were brown and dry. Sometimes we passed small villages. They seemed to be flying by. Do you know that when the train is at a very high speed, things outside seem to be running in the opposite direction? Earlier, it was really hot. Now that is evening, there is some breeze. So in the afternoon, some of the people went to sleep, but Omana did not want to sleep. You don't sleep, no? Small children always like to look out of the train, see the fields, the trees, everything that is going on outside, and that it is so much fun. She said that the fields were brown and dry. Do you know why? Probably because it was the summer vacation. Summers are hot, aren't they? She passed by some villages. And when they were passing by the villages, she thought that the villages seemed to be flying by. because the train was at a very high speed. Okay. Now, in the afternoon, it was very hot. But by the time it became evening, a cool breeze started blowing. The sun is slowly setting and the sky has become orange. I have never seen it look like this in Ahmedabad. We have just passed a station called Valsad. The train stopped only for 2 minutes, but even for the short time, there was so much noise. Chai, garam chai, one man was calling. Batata vada, batata vada. So this is one very entertaining thing that happens in all platforms, especially when the train stops. So many people get into the train trying to sell you goodies, trying to sell you tea, coffee, cold drinks and all different types of eatables. And you really feel like having each and everything that they are selling, don't you? So this is what even Omana experienced. Puri shak, doodh, thanda doodh. People were selling and buying food on the platform. We quickly bought some bananas and chikus through the window itself. Now tell me, what did Omana see from the window? She saw many fields and villages from the window. And she also saw the setting sun, didn't she? What are some of the things that are sold at the railway station? Can you tell me? What are the things that are sold at railway stations? I'm sure you must have noticed. Yes, books, toys, fruits, milk, ice creams, tea, biscuits, cold drinks, hot snacks. There are so many things, right? So you can put them down here, okay? I have made some friends. They are Sunil and Anne. They are going to their grandmother's house in Kozhikode. Sunil has given me some story books to read. A little while ago, I went to brush my teeth, but there was no water in the bathroom. Somebody said that it will only be filled at the next big station. So Omana made new friends in her coach. There was a boy named Sunil and a girl named Anne. They both were going to their grandmother's house in Kozhikode. Sunil shared some of his books with her. Omana wanted to go and brush her teeth. But unfortunately, there was no water in the bathroom. Do you know why? Because so many people in the coach have to use the same bathrooms, right? So the water sometimes gets over. Then they fill the water at the next station. Let's read the next question. Why do you think there was no water in the bathroom of the train? Discuss. Like I had said before, children, there are almost 72 passengers in one coach of the train. Alright? And how many bathrooms? Two on each side. So there are four bathrooms. So many people have to share four bathrooms. So what happens? Sometimes the water gets over. Alright? So that is why they refill it in the next station. So that's why when we are traveling in a train, we should use water sparingly. Okay, we should not waste water. Imagine that you are going on a long train journey. What are the things you will take with you to help pass the time? You can write down, children, here. So I think we can carry books, magazines, because when you read, you don't know how time flies. Then if you're interested in listening to music, then you can carry your MP3 player. You carry your games, all the travel games like cards, Uno, Ludo, chess. All these help us in passing our time, right? So we can carry these things. Can you recognize who are these people shown in the picture and what work they do? Discuss. So now let's see what's the first picture. Yes, this person is carrying luggage. So who's he? He is a porter. He helps us with our luggage. Okay? The second picture is that of the guard. Can you see him holding two flags? One is green and the other is red. So when the train has to move, he waves the green flag. And when the train has to come to a halt, he waves the red flag. So this is the guard. The third picture is that of the loco pilot, or as we know him, the train driver. He drives the train. The fourth picture is that of the ticket checker or the ticket collector. He checks our tickets. The fifth picture is of the railway police. They see to it that there are no miscreants on the train. Okay? They protect the passengers. The sixth picture is that of the cleaner. He keeps the platform and also the train coaches clean. The seventh picture is that of the booking clerk. The booking clerk helps book our train tickets. With that, children, we come to the end of the first part of Omana's journey. We will learn what happened in the next part of her journey in the next lesson from the window. Okay? Now, I want you to read the lesson carefully and complete all the question answers that are given in the textbook. Alright, I will also be sending you the answers. So till then, you can complete your work. Okay, so till we meet again, children, stay safe, stay healthy. Good day, children.